Oh, hey there. So today we're gonna be showing you the process of how all of our amazing pottery items are made right here, locally, USA made. That was something that I really wanted to happen, find a local potter. It's so much cooler than buying from out of the country. So we're gonna show the whole process with Jeremy, or as I like to call him, Pottery Dude. We've got everything from our salt jar, to our pie plates, to our plates, to our cute new mixing bowls. It's gonna be the best time ever to watch the whole thing. So let's go, come on. This is Pottery Dude. Don't you love your name?
Yeah, I know. That's my new name now.
He's the best. Jeremy, tell him a little bit like about us and like how we got started.
So the Food Nanny building is not that far away. My wife's a big Food Nanny. Fanny, I guess you'd call him.
That's
so
why we hired him.
She said, you should make stuff for the Food Nanny because we've been doing pottery for like 20 years.
Right.
So we took some stuff over and we got blown off, I think. And then
I still don't know this story. Like, what did you bring?
I can't even remember. It
See?
Was like a pie dish.
It's like, okay.
Anyway, so like a year later, somehow we got connected.
I was playing hard to get.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah.
Okay, so this is the forming area. So this is where they make it, you know, like from start, right? With the clay, right? Am I saying it right, Jeremy?
Yeah, it's clay. Okay, so.
With the clay.
We have a forming process where we stamp out the basic shape on what we call a press. And then we put it on the pottery wheel and we form it, shape it, handle it. So this is the clay.
Tell them how this is lead free. We get asked all the time.
Yeah, it's lead free. So you throw the clay in the mold.
Look at that.
So that's squeezing the clay into a mold. And then it pushes air through these molds. Come on, it'll take a little bit. You can see it starting to get some fog there.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So that gives us our basic form. And some people are like, you know what, that's not art. You didn't, you know, hand make it. But it gives us a little head start. But
yeah.
I mean, we still have to make that look good, you know?
No, are you kidding me? Like, what do you do with the batter bowl? You then have to make the handle.
Yeah,
isn't machines just doing it all day long.
No. I mean, sometimes we wish we had robots. So, the general form, we put it on the wheel. And the nice thing here, this can go a lot of directions on the shape. So, for example, on the teacup, Lizi said, we need a certain height. You just hate big mugs, right?
I do.
You hate them.
I hate them.
Yeah.
It's so, too much.
Which is nice because if we have direction, you know, we're good. And this is where you do have to be a bit of an artist because there's really no way to standardize this. So Lizi will tell us the form, give us the sample approval once we go through a lot of phases. We'll get the first one and Lizi will go try it and make sure it fits the bill. It's Food Nanny approved, Food Nanny quality.
Right.
But then we have to have the ladies be able to recreate it. So, I mean, the first couple hundred, I mean, we're just recycling. I mean, we're like throwing away a good half of them because it takes them just time to get the subtleties of the shape and form.
Isn't that insane?
So, yeah. This is the salt jar. And there's a lot of steps in pottery. We call this greenware. It means the clay's been dry, but it hasn't been fired. And it's been nice and sponge smooth. We got the little logo.
It's the best.
So this is the green, we're in the greenware room right now. And then we're moving into glazing. Here's the batter bowl again before it's been glazed. So this is one of the glazing areas. So we have these really fancy 50-gallon drums that we've cut the front out of. And so we spray in here and every piece is sprayed with a couple colors.
Wait, this is before the kiln.
Before the kiln.
Yeah, but why do you have to spray it again before?
Well, we're putting the glaze on.
Oh, the glaze.
Yeah.
Okay,
the glaze,
and then this is the finish.
And then once we fire it, yeah. And
look how cool.
Yeah, so the thing about glazing, it's easy to get a good looking glaze. It's really hard to get a glaze that's good looking and durable. So that's kind of where we crack the code.
Right.
But that's not easy. So we knew the dough hook needed to be able to just go crazy
do
its job.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was a miracle, but it was on the fly, figuring out a problem on the fly.
See, he's that good.
Whatever.
He is good.
Not me.
He is. He's modest. He's good.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, okay.
sorry.
Jeremy?
Sorry.
Okay. Yeah.
So pottery's dirty, as you can see in the factory, but Lizi comes in always looking nice.
And it's fine.
But she handles it great.
I handle it great.
You
do. I mean, I live on a farm.
You're
Jeremy.
Right. I forget. You're
okay.
Right. You just look nice.
That's
okay.
Nice. That's
okay.
Nice.
This is the batter bowl we make for Lizi. We designed. She came up with the design, whatever.
I'm obsessed with it.
Yeah. These are some of our gas kilns here. And as you can see, we can only fit so many pieces in there. And these kilns are hard to come by. You can see they're not pretty, but they're hard to get your hands on because there's not very many of them. So we went to Texas and we went big, and maybe too big. I don't know. We'll see. It's big.
Maybe too big. Ah!
Yeah.
Bigger in Texas, right?
Yeah,
that's what they say? I feel like you're the best potter I've ever seen.
Oh, wow.
Right?
Okay.
I'm being serious. That's why you work with me.
Yeah, I love it.
Tell them what we've done so far. We've done the batter bowl. We've done...
Salt jar.
Oh, yeah, the salt jar.
Yeah, we started out with the pie dish. That was kind of your first signature.
Oh, yeah, the pie dish.
We did the pie dish. We do the little pie weights. We've got more to come.
We have so much more to come.
We have more to come. The ideas are in your head.
Endless.
And they're in mine.
But you know what I love too? Is Jeremy's got a whole family run business just like me.
Yeah, it is family run.
Yeah.
Very family run.
Okay, now we're gonna go see the kiln that he just got. So this is what I'm so excited to see.
So this is the kiln we brought back. And I think it was a good idea. But the jury's still out. My brother went with us and he was cursing. Well, not really cursing, but he thought it was crazy.
Really?
Well, it was just, I mean, look at it. It's huge.
I mean, this is the biggest thing. Yeah. Well, I don't really know kilns,
okay.
I know, but that is huge.
Yeah, it's huge.
I mean, this seriously looks like it's a ship.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is amazing. So the reason you got it though is because you want to ramp up production.
Yeah, so we're somewhat bottlenecked on just the firing capacity we have.
Yeah.
And it was a once in a lifetime opportunity. It came out of a dinnerware plate in Texas that was making just plates for restaurants and like cruise ships. And they made the Denny's mug. They
I
were
mean,
super
that's
proud
the coolest
of that.
Story.
I know, I have a couple. I want to go to Denny's now.
Is this what goes inside?
Yeah. Okay. So the crazy thing about this is what's called a kiln shelf. This sits in the kiln and all your pottery sits on it. These are ridiculously expensive if you buy them new.
Really?
Just like, I mean, we would have had to save up for so long to get these, but this company just had crates of these. And they said, if you get the kiln, this goes with it.
This many crates?
Yeah, so all this.
Do you have extra or that's how many it takes to fill this?
It will take about this many to fill it.
Holy.
Yeah. Because it has two carts and the kiln slides back and forth. But I mean, it's weird, but like this really means a lot to me because I know how much these cost.
Wow, no,
so
I get
it. Oh, wow. We've dealt with some other companies like Sur La Table or whatever, like those retail chains, and it was so cutthroat. They would come in and just demand this price, and so we're like, no more, it's too cutthroat. Like they don't get what a small business is. And then Lizi came along and we started supplying you and Lizi gets it. So it was like, what price do you need? And we were like, wait, what?
He was like, I've never heard that before.
What
I'm like,
price
well,
do you
we need?
Need
to make it good for both of us.
Yeah. So
that's what I'm proud of.
Yeah. No. And so that's what actually makes it possible because you need that to survive American made. You really do. So anyway.
Makes me want to cry.
Yeah, it's true though.
Okay. I'm headed off to my other jobs.
Okay.
See you later. Wasn't that so much fun? I just love working with all these little small businesses like me. And how they're passionate to get you the best product out there. Come on. This is one of my favorite combos going on, our new pink French bowl. Look at it. Of course, with our dough cook, I use this thing all day, every day. But what a fun field trip. Thank you for coming and watching. We've got many more to come. We're just getting started. So thank you and see you on the next one.